who is educated up to 5th standard, occupied as a laborer, and he is resident of Ujire district, Karnataka. History was given by patient and his mother. Chief complaint, complaint of dyspnea on exertion from 2 years, complaint of bluish discoloration of skin and mucous membrane from 1 year, and complaint of violet.
1 year from age or last 1 year?
From last 1 year, sir.
Okay, 1 year.
And yes. Bilateral lower limb swelling from last 2 months.
Mm. 2 months, okay, fine.
Yes, sir. History of presenting illness. Sir, there is important childhood history in my patient, so I would like to describe it first. Patient was born of a non-contiguous marriage, full-term normal vaginal delivery at home. There were no perinatal complications and no history of maternal infection or prolonged drug intake during pregnancy. As per patient's mother, during infancy, patient was admitted to the hospital for complaints of hurried breathing, cough and fever about near 3 to 4 months of age, and was treated with IV medications and nebulizations. At this time, mother was told that the child is having a hole in heart and will need surgery for it. And also there was history of similar type of hospital admissions about 4 to 5 times up to 2 years of age. After that, patient was asymptomatic till 30 years of age.
What happened? Recurrent lower respiratory infection in a childhood.
Only two years of age, sir. At that time, there was no history of feeding difficulty or suck cycle or sweating over forehead. And after that, patient was asymptomatic till 30 years of age. And now patient has complaint of dyspnea on exertion from last 2 years, insidious in onset, gradually progressive. Initially was on walking of more than 1 kilometer, climbing more than 3 flights of stairs, and gradually progressed now over a period of 2 years. So that patient is having now marked dyspnea on his usual work at his workplace, which is interfering with his work, but there is no dyspnea at rest. There is complaint of bluish discoloration of skin and mucous membrane from last 1 year, which is involving all 4 limbs and tongues and lips. And complaint of bilateral lower limb swelling from last 2 months. Swelling are up to ankle, and patient is telling is feeling more toward end of the day, and it disappears on waking up on the morning. And no complaint of orthopnea or PND, no complaint of cough or hemoptysis, no complaint of chest pain or palpitation, no complaint of giddiness or loss of consciousness, no complaint of headache, blurring of vision, any limb weakness or seizure, no complaint of any prolonged fever. Sir, growth and development history.
Hemorrhoid diathesis, any bleeding diathesis?
No, sir. No bleeding diathesis.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Sir, growth and development history?
Synoptic heart disease patient, no? You have to describe this, no? Many things like, first of all, these symptoms of hyperviscosity and any blood letting and symptoms of any hematological or any hemorrhagic diathesis.
Yes.
Okay, not fine.
No, I had a complaint of headache or blurring of vision or limb weakness was there.
In any history of any intercranial abscess or any. What is headache? Why do you have a headache? Or what is the cause of headache in case of synoptic glandular disease?
Sir, headache, one, it can be due to hyperviscosity symptom. Other, it can also be due to intracranial complications like brain abscess, or there may be cortical venous sinus thrombosis, or there may be CV stroke because of steroid optical embolism. Sir, growth and development history. Patient's mother did not report any growth delay, and patient achieved a developmental milestone appropriate for age. Sibling history. Patient had two elder brothers. Both are healthy, and no, there is no significant family history present. Personal history. Patient is mixed by diet. Appetite and sleep are normal. Bowel bladder habit are normal, and nil addiction.
Okay. So from history, very patient is very have symptoms of very short duration, 2 years only. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
This, why is breathlessness? You told patient is mildly dizzy. Why is he dizzy? He has got no pulmonary venous happiness, and which is not there.
Yes, sir.
I mean, disease is not, no, you have no pulmonary venous pressure normal here. No pulmonary venous pressure is.
Yes, sir. Sir, we are considering, because patient is also having history of cyanosis and infantile history of respiratory tract infection. So we consider cyanotic congenital heart disease. In these such cases, because of hypoxia, there is stimulation of the respiratory centers and the chemoreceptors present in brainstem and aortic arch and carotid body. This leads to tachypnea and sensation of dyspnea.
Okay. How the patients get relief of dyspnea? Are you taking rest or in assuming some squatting posture or on taking rest only?
On taking rest only. He did not tell any about any squatting, sir.
Okay, fine. So, tell me what diagnosis you are putting forth.
Yes, sir. So, considering this history, the infantile history of early childhood history of frequent respiratory tract infections, and now again patient developing symptom of dyspnea and cyanosis. So, I am considering here, sir, congenital heart disease. Initially, patient was having shunt physiology, left to right shunt, and now has developed Eisenmenger physiology, and it can be said pre-tricuspid level considering patient's age of presentation.
But you told that when you develop respiratory infection, pre-tricuspid shunt having so much lower respiratory infection admitted in the hospital.
Yes, sir. Up to 2 years of age. Yes.
That too we develop. That too we. It only is 2 years of age. Thereafter, it becomes asymptomatic 30 years of age.
Yes, sir.
Why do you think like that? Pre-tricuspid shunt, yes. Even asymptomatic after 2 years of age, why the patient develops so much age early?
Yes, sir.
Pre-tract shunt, HD or what? HD or TP, you think? What do you think? Pre-tract shunt or many things, na? Tell me, what are the pre-tricuspid shunts? What are the
pre-tricuspid? Pre-tricuspid includes ASD, ASD with PAPVC, TAPVC,
PAPVC also, PAPVC intact IS, no?
Yes.
Okay. So what do you think from history, which variety of shunt you are thinking?
Sir, it may be ASD.
But why the patient develop so much of respiratory infection that you recount respiratory infection, admitted, hospitalized, getting oxygen, and that will become asymptomatic 2 years of age. Why? What the pathophysiology here becoming symptomsless at the age of 2 years?
This for isolated ASD, sir, it goes against this point. Otherwise, if it is ostium primum like ASD or ASD with PA PVC or very large ASD, it can be there. But
again, at 2 years space, they will develop so much PS. Even before 5 years space, so much PS in ASD patient develop whatever may be ASD, PA PVC, could be single atrium or a common atrium or ostium primum ASD.
Yes, sir. So that's why, sir, post-tricuspid we can also not deny at this stage.
But then why not post-tricuspid? Because if your ostium continued, okay, you have like respiratory infection continue for 10 years, 12 years, 13 years, like that. And that, yes. how often case of ASD patient develop a recurrent respiratory infection and requires hospitalization?
Yes, sir, it is very less common in ASD. That's why I also would like to put post-tricuspid shunt.
Oh, no. There is someone on your editorial has described all the hoops sounds not because zebras, no? All the irregular fever for continues for a long time is not because of brucellosis. You have tuberculosis. Could be brucellosis. Yes. So you should go by commonness. It may be wrong.
Yes,
go by commonness. So patient become asymptomatic at age of 2 years. So past should be post sometimes can't be tricuspid from ASD.
Yes.
Okay, continued for like this and the frequency also diminished, but it's continued for 4-5 times a year, continue for 10-12 years, 13 years. Okay, you can think of like this. But still I won't think of ASD from ASD. The age of 2 years, patient asymptomatic means patient developed significant PAs which curtail the QP such extent that patient becomes symptom free.
Yes, sir.
So, depending on history, you should tell that okay, there is sound physiology because there is diagnosis of sound, not patient's analysis, sound physiology. But I'm thinking of distal to post-practice patient. Depends upon many factors. Progression of disease depends on many factors.
Yes.
There could be large sound, initial large hole, that the hole come down. Hole might have size might have come down.
Yes, sir.
So, patient is asymptomatic from 2 years to 30 years.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, right. Which type of pre-tricuspid developed PH frequently? Okay, ASD with PAPBs. But at the age of 2 years now, ASD PAPBs. Single atrium. So, this is a single atrium, again, you have to have sinuses. No sinuses in your side.
Yes.
Only one interesting is history in your apprentice knee that is if patient has a pre-tricuspid sound, then no history is suggestive of heart failure. Left heart failure is not there. Only
yes.
Patient has increased pulmonary blood flow history there. No, there is a repeated respiratory infection, but the no history suggestive of heart failure.
Yes.
So that is there. But again, the patient had become asymptomatic at the age of 2 years. Very difficult to explain in the term of pre-tricuspid shunt.
Yes, sir.
So what are the types of shunt-related PAs, you know? There are four types of shunt-related PAs. You know that? You know? No?
That's one is the... because of hyperkinetic pulmonary artery hypertension related to shunt. Second one is the due to development of Eisenmengerization. Third one is the due to the shunt is a bystander lesion. It is not contributing to the development of pulmonary hypertension in the patients. And fourth is the pulmonary artery hypertension that develops or persists or progress after the correction of the shunt.
Yeah, you told four types. Only thing you change the order. So first is hyperkinemia,
second is
hyperkinic PH.
Yes, sir.
So what the difference between hyperkinic PH and isomugral PH?
Hyperkinetic pH is to increase pulmonary blood flow. There will be symptoms of respiratory tract infections and cardiomegaly will be there present. And in fixed obliterative pH, there will be there will not be features of increased pulmonary blood flow. Cardiomegaly will not be there. And sir, main feature, there flow murmur will be absent in case of mid diastolic flow murmur will be absent in case of obliterative pH.
This case I have given you some hemodynamically to we'll discuss the case. Happening the pH, suppose BH happening the pH versus BH with the isomer pH, part of the P pressure. Now, the person you take the pressure, blood pressure in the upper limb, blood pressure in the right arm, you got it 110 by 70, okay?
Yes,
sir. And I'm talking BHD, case I have BHD. Then the hyperkinetic pH for the PE pressure and the obstructive pH for the PE pressure. Just one, I'm not telling that exactly. So I want to know, I want to understand. I want to know how much you have got hemodynamic concepts. Hyperkinetic pH is BHD and isomugral pH is BHD and blood pressure 110 by 70.
Sir.
Tell me. P pressure.
Pulmonary artery pressure in case of main pulmonary will be more than 25 millimeter mercury in pulmonary hypertension.
Both are pulmonary hypertension. Both pulmonary hypertension. Actually, no. I am giving the blood pressure between 110 and 70 or right upper limb blood pressure. When outer pressure 110 and 70. Fine. Out of pressure 170, what could be pressure in hyperkinetic pH and what could be pressure in isomugral pH?
Yes, data I don't know, sir.
Chetan, are you
there? I'm here.
Until.
Sir, in non-restrictive VSD, if blood pressure is 110 by 70, means LV pressure will be 100. So RV pressure will be 100 and PE systolic pressure will be also 100. And if we consider RV and diastolic pressure around 7 to 8, so this is hyperkinetic pH. So there will be wide pulse pressure between in PA. Diastolic pressure should be, pulse pressure should be more than 60% of systolic pressure. So, PA end diastolic pressure will be around 40. So, mean will be around 60, sir.
And fixed pH, general pH?
Sir, white pulse pressure will be less, there will be no white pulse pressure. So diastolic PA pressure will go up and transpulmonary gradient will be more than 7, sir.
Diastolic gradient?
Sorry, diastolic pulmonary gradient.
What?
Sorry, sir. There will be no white pulse pressure.
So, you understood your name is Kashyap.
Yes, sir.
You understood short term. Because the patient has got PA. See, the patient had hyperkinetic PH. Only the systolic pressure is raised. Systolic pressure is PA systolic pressure equal to your RV systolic pressure.
Yes, sir.
If you think about non restrictive PhD, even you also some amount of mild restrictive PhD or something, you know, your LV pressure is 110, RV pressure is 100, supposing. Or 90, even 90 also. So, PA will be 90. Even non-extreme BHD, P per to RV. Okay, take it a non-extreme BHD. So LV 110 and RV 110 and P is 110. But as the hyperkinetic P is, so patient has not developed obliterate changes, pulmonary vasculitis are not elevated much. So diastolic pressure is not raised.
Yes, okay.
So diastolic pressure, little more maybe little more than that your pulmonary voice pressure. So maybe some 90/30, 90/20, something like that, white pulse pressure, because the pulmonary vascular resistance is low.
Yes, sir.
These are other conditions.
Yes, sir.
So once you, once the patient develop changes in the pulmonary circulation, there is ovulatory changes and there is cavernous malformation, pyxoderm lesion, so, and there is, you know, there is decrease density of the capillaries and small arteries, so your diastolic pressure will go. So pulse pressure become narrow.
Yes, sir.
So the pulse pressure will be less than 40% of your systolic pressure.
Yes, sir.
When pulse pressure will become narrow, or when the diastolic pressure is goes up, or the diastolic pressure, you would think the patient is approaching towards agile mode.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so first diagnosis, first the short-related pH is your Eisenmenger, second is hypercholemia, third is bystander, as we told. There it is, but this not is the sound is small enough to explain the pH. And fourth is progression of pulmonary hypertension after intervention, after closure of the defect.
Yes, sir.
After four is more dangerous, is fourth is more malignant. So there is early progression of fat pillar and death. Third is like idiopathic pH.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so why not it's a case of, why do you think of pH? Why do you think case of VHD pH?
Sir, in VHD pH, once there will be, means acquired VHD pH is there, acquired pH, then at this age, majority they will be asymptomatic. And if they become symptomatic, main symptom will be dyspnea on exertion. Cyanosis will be very uncommon in these patients. And also, this is the main reason. Otherwise,
you might develop some arbitrary obstruction at age of 2 years, so that reduce pulmonary blood flow. And over the years, over the progression of disease, now develop cyanosis, why not?
Sir, majority of patient, they behave like reduced left to right shunt only. Such patients.
No, that's you know. See, why I'm asking, why I'm discussing the case now? It has the depression that's significant enough to produce respiratory infection, but not enough to produce heart failure. Patient knows his heart, mother to know his heart failure. That's sucking, sucking without any difficulties, as mother used to feed. The baby without any difficulties, no post-pulmonary sweating, no tachypnea, nothing. So there are no histories of the heart failure, there is no history of failure to gain weight. So what I'm thinking, there is some amount of obstruction, maybe there is not enough. Understand? But enough to have a leptoid sound and their sound-related infection. Now you would slowly progression of the RVOT obstruction, now the patient become cyanotic and dyspneic, why not it is? You understand my question?
Yes, sir.
Am I here?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Understand. At this point, we cannot differentiate, sir, probably from history.
Yeah, only thing that you got to develop the early history, early history of cyanosis, because 32 years very too much, it is out of gap there. So we would have developed cyanosis and symptoms much earlier.
Yes, sir.
The only thing that. But that is also some, though it is not very common, but you can second diagnosis, so you can keep it.
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is straightforward case because patient has got only thing that you should not tell is a case of pre-tax person. Because only has become asymptomatic 2 years of age. So that's why I'm thinking it's not a pre-tax. You can't think of a pre-tax person.
Yes, sir.
Okay, finding what exam is finding?
Sir, general examination. Patient is conscious, cooperative, and well-oriented to time, place, and person. Height is 160 centimeter. Weight is 50 kilogram. BMI is 20 kilogram per meter square. Temperature is normal. Pulse is 88 per minute, regular rhythm, normal volume, no radioradial or radiofemoral delay. All peripheral pulses well felt. blood pressure 120 by 80 in right upper limb, 126 by 80 in left upper limb, 130 millimeter aim of mercury in lower limbs, respiratory rate is 20 per minute, regular abdominothoracic. JVP is 6 centimeter from sternal angle of Lewis, means 11 centimeter of water and 8 millimeter of mercury with prominent A wave, normal descents and normal respiratory variation. Central cyanosis is present. Grade 2 clubbing is present, pan-digital clubbing. SpO2 is 83% in all four limbs. Conjunctival suffusion is present. Bilateral pitting pedal edema just above ankle present. No icterus, no lymphadenopathy, back and spine normal. No facial dysmorphism. Oral cavity hygiene is normal. Systemic examination on cardiovascular system, inspection and palpation. Chest is bilaterally symmetrical, trachea is central, apex bit is in left fifth intercostal space on mid-clavicular line, diffuse with lateral retraction, RV type of apex. Palpable second heart sound is present in left second intercostal space. Parasternal heave grade 2 present. Epigastric pulsations RV type present. No dilated veins, scar or sinuses. On percussion, upper border of liver dullness is in right fifth intercostal space in mid clavicular line. Stomach tympani on left side. Apex coincides with left heart border. Right heart border is retrosternal. Left second intercostal space is dull. On auscultation.
Left second intercostal dull. Where it is dull? Where in axilla or in parasternally or
mid? Just lateral to the sternal border. Left second intercostal space. On auscultation, first heart sound is normal. Second heart sound is single and loud. It is P2. Ejection click is present in left second intercostal space, just lateral to the sternal border. It does not vary with respiration. This one, pan-systolic murmur is present at lower left sternal border. High pitch, glowing, plate 2 configuration, grade 2 by 6. It does not change with respiration or leg raising. There is no S3 or S4 and no other murmur. On other systems are normal, sir.
So pulmonary is just a click and you get edema more.
Yes.
So what is your final?
Diagnosis.
Yes, sir. You got a click and a non-variable. This constant click, we got a paracetamol load down 2x6 only. 2x6.
Yes, sir.
Not very great murmur, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Sir, it is situs solitus levocardia, post tricuspid shunt, probably VSD, with features of right heart failure, in patient in functional class 3, with sinus rhythm. And no evidence of infective endocarditis.
Only thing that now, what is a pulmonary edema? Which pulmonary edema? There is just a click there, out click and no murmur. So if you have there early atrial murmur, no doubt. No, yesterday they got early atrial murmur, so there no doubt of what is that? I don't know the figure. But you are not getting any kind of murmur in pulmonary area. There is no evidence of clear there.
Yes,
sir. What do you think of green tea pulmonary edema. I said, going to now, 30 years of age now, going to ask you now, long term green pulmonary edema, or long term top pulmonary edema. Is it not there? Are we still living? Is it not there?
Yes, I didn't get that.
Respecting
or no? Yes, I respect him because patient is in features of right heart failure, pedal edema, raised JVP.
So why don't you call me to pulmonary edema?
Usually TR murmur we don't get right heart failure.
No, Maraguli, to not get done. I'm not getting TR murmur. I'm not convinced that patient has got PH and TR. PH here.
Sir, there is a...
In the second term.
Yes, sir. There is not...
QT is absent here. No, I'm thinking that. QT is absent. You got a click. So what happened? Yes, anodic patient. You got a click. Second, I'm saying, I'm asking about the pulmonary edema.
Sir, here there are features of pulmonary hypertension are there, like parasternal heave is there, grade 2 epigastric pulsations are there, left second intercostal space is dull. All the features of pulmonary hypertension. So in pulmonary atresia, we don't get such features. Yes, right ventricular pressure will be similar to the systolic blood pressure, sir. Pressure will be 120 milliliter mercury systolic.
Did you think of iron number? Which iron number? Why is pressure 120? Okay, hypothetically, if you presume that, if you see this group of pulmonary atresia, but iron pressure how much?
In VHD pulmonary atresia, sir.
What is iron pressure? Let us presume it.
It will be same, sir.
Same, sir. Then what? We both are same, sir. If our person is getting there, we could have got here also. Personally, we are getting because it's the same. So, in the case of all these permanent, probably we could have got it.
These features are reflection of pulmonary artery hypertension. We are getting. We don't get, sir, usually.
Why? Pulmonary patient has got no single ventricular pulmonary atresia.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Any mal patient get atresia? Get it. Why not?
Yes, sir.
Why not, sir? Why not?
Yes, sir.
So very difficult to differentiate because you are not getting any evidence of direct evidence of pre-dilatation. You are getting only second space at all. So you hardly usually out, even you dilated also won't get left second space dull node in case of VHL polymerization unless there is L malpassing great arteries.
Yes.
So you have to take a history into account. So history is there from beginning, there is a hole in the heart and the history suggests of the left heart some significant sign. So now patient develop VHL case, not VHL pulmonary arteriosclerosis. And that to VHL pulmonary arteriosclerosis, patient is alive to this age, you have to get evidence of collaterals, automatal, no? Baka, major arterial collaterals. So not getting evidence.
Yes.
There are no evidence of automatic collaterals.
Yes, sir.
So you have to make argument like this.
Yes, sir.
Otherwise, very difficult to do because there is no median. Only one click there.
Yes,
sir. So you will get a click, outy click, outer dilated, you get outy vascular click, and single sound single because PP is absent. And because outer dilated, and the right LV stroke output, biminal stroke output will be great big. So we may get A2 very loud also because outer dilated and the elastic recoils outer is brisk, we may get A2 loud. So,
yes.
Understand? So,
yes, sir.
So, VHD, why not you told at beginning HD there, no? You told, why not why you change your diagnosis now, VHD? Why not HD, UTP, PVC? Something like that, so has given rise to Eisenmenger. Why not HT?
Sir, mainly
TR goes in favor of HT, you can get it here. So all the TR can first leave there and from and JVP, A is greater than V, and why not it is HT?
Mainly on second heart sound, in ASD Eisenmenger, we will get wide fixed split with loud P2. Here I am getting single second heart sound. Otherwise, no other points against ASD is the major.
Otherwise, no other point against, correct. Okay, only the sound, you have to discuss the case, like you don't give diagnosis and just see. So you have to take these cases of central TPS. Discuss like this, so I'm getting these things from the way my personal time there. I'm going in for each, but second sound is single, which usually get single sound is split in both phases expression and it is when fixed up. So it is a very important sign for each as manga. I'm not getting it. Whereas the other findings are in favor of each as manga. VHD, second sound single, and permanent wave and partial lift. So partially nothing. RV impulse only. RV are getting apex or same impulse getting in partial area. So understand. So only thing that your second sound single goes in favor of strongly goes in favor of VHD as in Mangar or AP window as in Mangar. AP window as in Mangar. Could be AP window? Possible. AP window as in Mangar what?
Usually Eisenmenger in first decade of life, they will not present so much later.
Why? What's the reason behind it? Only BHT has the equipment same, no? Lipterson. All thing is inside, is outside heart.
So there will be both, the shunt will be both in systolic and diastolic phase. In VHD only shunt will be then systolic phase. So increase amount of pulmonary blood flow. It will lead to early Eisenmengerization in AP window.
Pressure and volume both transmitted. Both systole diastolic pressure as well as blood transmit flow transmit pulmonary circuit. So patient get early yes. So everything is same thing. Second sound single and you may get and informed sinuses, and PD will get informed sinuses, or you will get informed sinuses. Only thing that is in here, only thing that you will get early.
Yes.
Otherwise, clinically very different depression between AP window Eisenmenger and VHD Eisenmenger.
Yes.
You discover all simple Eisenmenger, VHD, VHD, and PD, present member, then the penalty will be most poorly because person has become absent at age of 2 years and second son single, and I'm thinking one now person account have failure right at the usually the most they usually they survey up to even 40, 50, 55 years is as in younger, and more of death is that day to hemoptysis, not hemoptysis. Hemoptysis is not caused by the death. It is heart failure, sudden cardiac death.
Yes.
Heart with arrhythmia, is the cause of common causes more of death.
Yes, sir.
To describe these things. Maybe it's not a complex angiomyogram or not a not no but like angiomyogram has developed so late, it's not other type of angiomyogram.
Yes.
Could it truncus better? Possible truncus.
Sir, also in same truncus artery says majority of the patients die within first year of life because of congestive cardiac failures, 90% mortality within first.
They will ask you the question like this. What are the conditions you get second sound single? Once the question asked, you should not take any time lag period. No lag period.
Yes, sir.
The question is finished from the exam's mouth and you start answer. Within 3 seconds, you complete the answer.
Yes, sir. Sir?
One second.
In all cardiac conditions, should I tell, sir? Sir, single second heart sound will be there in severe aortic stenosis, severe pulmonary stenosis, and in patient with severe pulmonary artery hypertension.
Answer, horrible answer. Severe aortic stenosis, you will get single second heart sound. Patient back of heart valve, I will get very nice paravical speed will get. But you see, go to common company, they start with BH pulmonary artists, absent pulmonary valve, go like this.
Yes, sir. The other causes are sir, single valve, like truncus arteriosus, that will be single. Then patient with tetralogy of Fallot, it will be single because pulmonary component is not audible. Patient is having either TGA or CCTJ because the anterior post aorta and posteriorly placed pulmonary trunk. We'll get single. And severe pulmonary hypertension, we'll get single second heart sound.
Severe pulmonary hypertension, we'll get single heart sound. Suppose the patient has got
VSD we can get single get
meet as a member tell that no
yes sir
meet as a member single ventricular as a member that's different
yes sir
sugar is a sugar casual cardiac sugar casual cardiac
yes
sir you can get single second sir
yes sir.
Okay, so this is at okay, so what is the ECG you have with you? Send ECG to person or you can
Yes sir, ECG is set up, yes sir.
This is a 12-lead ECG with normal standardization, and it is showing, sir, QRS axis is near 120 to 130 degree. There is a P pulmonale is present, sir, and sir, there is a
Listen, listen, don't mention P-Polmonary. Right atrial abnormality mention. Don't mention P-Polmonary. P-Congenital, don't mention it. Right atrial abnormality is there, but right atrial enlargement can say also.
Right atrial enlargement is there. And sir, there is incomplete right bundle branch block with RVH with the strain pattern is there, sir. And there is an absence of in Q wave in V5, V6, sir. And that's it. And sir, it is, sorry, sir, it is a sinus rhythm with the rate is around 80 beats per minute, sir.
So income to RBB is how ranks RBH in the place of income to RBB?
Sir, in present of incomplete RBB, if the R wave amplitude in lead V1 is more than 10 millimeter is there, then we say it is RBH is present, sir.
Okay, so RBH is there. So X-ray?
X-ray is there. Can Bhushan, can you show the X-ray or just I read, sir?
Yeah, X-ray I'm seeing now. X-ray, also Bhushan, is this now? Okay, X-ray I'm seeing. X-ray just you can get.
Yes, sir. Our X-ray, plain X-ray chest PA view with slightly rotated film. With sir, cardiac silhouette appears near mildly enlarged, and RV type of contour is there, and main pulmonary artery is hugely dilated, right pulmonary artery is hugely dilated, and the peripheral pruning of pulmonary vasculature is seen, sir.
How to pulmonary window? Radialist window. Out of pulmonary radial window, it is obliterated or it is there. I'm not able to become get very small, very minuscule picture here. Out of, show me the out of pulmonary radial window. Out of pulmonary radial window. This outer. This is sorry, trachea. Go down. Down. Trace from outer to outer gas to pulmonary artery. That is your window. That is obliterated or not obliterated? So, what do you think of seeing ECG and X-ray? What is your diagnosis?
Sir, it more goes in favor of pre-tricuspid ASD as a manger.
Yes, it looks like ASD as a manger. RPA dilated too much. Yeah? RPA dilated. Yes, and P also dilated. So, it looks like the contour looks like as if it is ASD as a manger. Only thing that RA is not much in RGR.
Yes, sir.
Are you not enlarged? It is LA enlarged there or is it rotated film?
It's rotated.
It is LA or it is RA or it is rotated film? Are you not enlarged?
Slightly rotated film.
What, Bhushan, are you able to see the X-ray there?
Yes, sir.
Rotated film and scoliosis also, sir.
Scoliosis is there. So from X-ray and ECG to seems like ECG as a pre-tricuspid, no?
Yes, sir.
This is RBB there, including RBB, and here your looks like, you know. Others are able to see, everybody seeing able to X-ray? Yes, sir. Everybody will see?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I'm thinking I'm only seeing, okay, fine.
So,
yeah, correct. Okay, echo, read out echo.
Yes, sir, full echo report I don't have, sir. Just, sir, it was, yes, sir, septaver intact, sir, both interatrial and interventricular septaver intact, and PDA was there, sir, large PDA.
That I'm telling, sir, outer pulmonary window looks obliterated to me here. See? Outer pulmonary window, there's no space at all. I'm seeing very small LA. And LA is worse than LA. not RA. Really large and outer polling window is totally obliterated.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine, you have to discuss like this, okay?
Yes, sir.
You discuss, goes like this.
Yes, sir.
But you have to mention somewhere else, all HD, BHD, PD, you have to, and you have to, this one, you have to discuss one by one.
JVP, because IVS is intact. In AP window, can we get, sir, raised JVP, sir? Because IVS is
intact. Same, but RPS is same, beginning RPS is equal, no? JVP won't raise any, none of the cases.
AP window also, yeah. Yes, sir.
Only thing that you, what that, early, first only, early, very early is manifestation, no, that's only thing.
Yes.
You are a JP raised because you had pillar. Patient have heart pillar now.
Yes, sir.
TR won't get, no, TR won't get agent member, post-tax TR won't get, unless patient go to RF dilatation. RF, any pressure overload and metal dilatation is there, is pillar. Auto stenosis, if you get cardiomegaly, brain and auto stenosis, cardiomegaly, there will be dysfunction. Otherwise, severe auto stenosis, even though gradient is more than 100-120 mmHg, but if there is no cardiomegaly, LV systolic function is retained. Once the cardiomegaly starts, LV dysfunction. Similarly, RV, whatever is RV, RV pressure, there if no cardiomegaly, RV function normal. If RV start dilate, RV dysfunction. So there here TR because RV dysfunction. And there is cardiomegaly.
Yes.
Cardiomegaly is. Actually, 32 years man, yes, but as a member. And only thing that you have to see, the outer pulmonary window is so nicely, it is obliterated. And LA or similar, so outer, I can't see the outer enlargement. But outer pulmonary window is reduced, the window is obliterated.
Yes, sir.
Discussion go like this. But even if you say PD as a member, you won't get much credit also. If you're not telling PD as a member, not losing any mark. But you have to discuss everything. PD as a member, like get BHD as a member, A as a member, HD as a member, discuss one by one. Then, okay, good.
Yes,
now, I think as a member is.